the flows of funds which advertisers and those who pay for marketing services have been constrained, and as has been pointed out, this has disrupted the revenue models of traditional media organizations. The numbers don't really indicate the real picture. When you have 100,000 publications registered with the print, with the Registrar of Newspapers of India, but you have one newspaper, the Times of India, which is the world's most widely circulated English daily newspaper. One out of two English newspapers sold in the country is an edition of the Times of India. You may have hundreds of radio stations, but we are arguably the only democracy in the world, or we call ourselves a democracy, where news and current affairs on radio is still a monopoly of the government. I mean, to think that in 1991 we had one broadcaster, and today we have something like 900 broadcasters that have been given permission to uplink or downlink, including 300 which claim they are news and current affairs channels, you know. Amitabh Bachchan, Siddharth, live breaking news, you know, Nag Nagin Ka Shadi, just picked up, Arnab Goswami is resigning from Times of India, he might tie up with Rajat Sharma, you know. News on the trot as we go, we are getting bombarded with huge amounts of information. We don't have anything called regulation, we have anarchy. We have half a dozen statutory regulatory bodies, and I don't need to elaborate on their state. Central Board of Film Certification, we have the Prime Minister's propagandist heading it. We have the Press Council of India. To describe it as a toothless tiger would be very charitable, because, you know, even a toothless tiger can scare somebody. You know, they're scared of that tiger, but the PCI can't scare anybody anymore. I used to be a member for 3 years of that council. You have the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. You have also the TRAI, the Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, when suddenly the rule book is shown to them and said, you know, you can't have so many advertising in every yard. Everybody goes to court saying, you want to kill us? You know, we are in a mess. You want to kill us now? So we have all these statutory bodies. We have something called the CERT, the Computer Emergency Response Team. We also have self-regulatory bodies, the BCCC. We have the News Broadcasting Standards Authority. But we actually have effectively regulatory anarchy and chaos currently prevailing. There have been a number of reports that have talked about the need for having restrictions on cross-media ownership, but these have not been implemented, including the recommendations of a parliamentary committee, an official report which the government had put together. Some of our television anchors have become akin to lynch mobs. I mean, they behave like lynch mobs. You know, they are baying for the blood of even their own fellow journalists. They want to put them behind bars, you know. How different are they from vigilante groups who want to lynch somebody because you don't like their religious beliefs or you don't like the meat that they're eating? We are in this mugs game called TRPs, the television rating points, which are farcical. Sukumar pointed out about NDTV. There was criminality. There was a former agent of the FBI who NDTV accessed a report which says that you are actually bribing people to, you know, fudge the ratings. That's because we have a very small number, a sample, trying to, you know, focus on urban areas, upper middle class areas, in trying to ascertain viewing patterns across a very diverse country. You don't have those people meters to figure out who's watching what in the hundreds of thousands of villages. But even this system is not only inadequate, it's corrupt completely and criminalized. So there are people who are actually bribing people to fudge those ratings. And this has been happening for a long time. You had one monopolist called TAM. Once that ended, now you have another monopolist called Bark. You know, so these are the new ways that we are seeing the way things have been evolving in the media in this country. We have to look at how we can make such journalism sustainable. Is it only philanthropies and trusts? Is it crowdfunding? Is it public support? These are the questions, I think, that we need to debate.